Good afternoon, good evening, and welcome to this session. And as you know the topic, we will be talking about floral formula. Ravi Kanda, good afternoon, good afternoon. How are you? How to interpret, how to write floral formula? That is what we will be discussing today. Check for the audio video, please. Can you hear me clearly? Ajit, namaste. Swaroop, good evening. I'm good, Swaroop, thank you. Pallavi, hello. Check for the audio video. Can you hear me clearly? Amit, Ahana. Jatin, good evening. Chiang. Akash, yes, okay, Ajit, everything is clear. Anna says clear, very good, very good. Nishchal. Epi. Prathima. Good afternoon, good afternoon. Kotai Mutu, Swaroop, audio video clear. Bhavika. Aziz. Akash, Vida. Sandeep, good evening. Amir, yes, all clear. Very good. Samson, I can hear you loud and clear. Perfect, perfect. Sandhya, good evening, good evening. AB, audio is good. Amit is saying everything is fine. Thiru, good evening. All good, all good. Nishchal is also saying all good. Okay, so let us get started with our topic, that is floral formula. This is a part, or this is a sub part, you can say, in the chapter of morphology of flowering plants. When we study morphology, there are three families of angiosperms which we study. There are three families in detail which we have to study in morphology. One is Fabaceae, Solanaceae, and Liliaceae. And how exactly we write the floral formula and what does the floral formula indicate, plus I will also tell you how you can distinguish between the formulae of these three families. So let me just give you some symbols first, and then I'm going to write a formula for you, and then we will interpret it. I'm sure you are aware of these symbols. In a circle, if we make plus sign, this means actinomorphic. This indicates that the flower is bilaterally symmetrical. It is radially symmetrical. That means it can be cut into equal halves through many planes. Similarly, if we are talking about bilaterally symmetrical, we write it like this. This is called zygomorphic. That means you can cut the flower only through one plane, that is bilateral. Here it is radially symmetrical. If a flower is bisexual, then we use the symbol for male as well as female on the same circle. Then we come to the whorls. The flower has four whorls: calyx, corolla, androecium, and gynoecium. Calyx represented by K, corolla represented by C, androecium represented by A, and gynoecium represented by G. These are simple abbreviations which we use. Now, calyx is made up of sepals. So, individual member, that is sepal, their number can be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 in different flowers and families. So, if those sepals are say 5, so we will write 5 here. Now, if these sepals are free, then we'll put this number like that. This condition is known as polysepalous condition. But if they are fused, we will write it as K5 and put this 5 in bracket. So this means gamosepalous, and this means polysepalous. Similarly, the petals can also be free and fused. So if they are free, we will call it polypetalous condition. We'll write the number as it is. And if the petals are fused, we will use the word gamopetalous.
and we'll put that number in the bracket. Same is applicable for androsium and gynosium. When we talk about gynosium, here we add one or two more things. Is the ovary superior or inferior? Superior ovary, we write G and a line below it. Inferior ovary, we write G and a line above G. The three families that we have in our syllabus all have this type of ovary. That means they all have hypogynous flower. Ovary is superior. So now you need to know the examples of these families. Say if you're talking about Fabaceae. In Fabaceae P, especially the Papilionaceae one, P is the important example. Then if you talk about Liliaceae family, lily flower is the important one, example. If you talk about Solanaceae family, Thathura is the most important example. So you take one example, and then in the family there are economic importance. So the questions which are asked are either on the family that identify whether this formula is of Liliaceae family, Fabaceae or Solanaceae. Or they can ask you the questions based on the name, example. Like they may give you the example like, okay, the formula is given. Is it of brinjal? Is it of soya bean? Is it of sun hemp? Or is it of tulip? So then you have to find out which belongs to which family and how do we interpret. So I'm going to write one formula for you and then we will try to interpret it. Let me write the complete formula. Just written one formula. Now just looking at it, it tells us that it is actinomorphic. That means formula is telling you the characteristics of a flower. So what do we interpret? Actinomorphic. That means you can cut the flower through radial plane, multiple planes. Like our China rose, you can cut it through many planes. It is bisexual. That means it has both the sex organ. Androsium is also there and a gynosium is also there. It can be bracteate or ebracteate. Bract is an extra whorl which is present outside calyx. Calyx, 5 sepals and they are free. Corolla, 5 petals and they are free. Androsium, 5 stamen free. Gynosium is unicarpillary ovary and it is superior. Now, if I give you the example of Papilionaceae family or Fabaceae family. Papilionaceae is the old name and the new name is Fabaceae. An example here that we take is of P. So now when I write the formula, it is zygomorphic, it is bisexual, calyx, 5 sepals fused, corolla. In Papilionaceae family, the corolla is very unique. The arrangement is there is one petal like this, there are two petals like this, and these two petals fused. So we write it as one petal, this bigger one, the two petals here, that is plus 2, and these plus 2 here, and these are fused. So this 2 is written in bracket. This is the characteristic feature of Fabaceae family. It is also known as vaxillary aestivation. So as soon as you see this, easy, you can easily decide that this is the formula of Fabaceae family. Then let us come to Androsium. Here the Androsium are like one here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and 9. And these 9 are fused. And this one is separate. So here we write it as 9 plus 1 and 9 is put in the bracket. Because these 9 are fused. And then in the center there is this ovary that is gynosium. Single carpal? See, how do we notice single carpal? You have all seen pea pod. So you, when you open that pea pod, you see all the seeds in one compartment. So it is unilocular ovary. So it is one and it is superior. All three families in our case, in our syllabus, are superior. So what have we understood from this? How the arrangement of the floral whorls is. So this is how we interpret the floral formula. So I hope this Fabaceae formula is clear to everyone. Any confusion in this formula? If you have any question, you can write in the text. I will read it and I'll find out what is your doubt. Okay, there are some students who have joined little late. We are discussing the floral formula and how to interpret it. If you have any confusion, you can write your question or the doubt. And if you have understood this, just write clear. Okay, Priya has written clear. Very good. What about others? Akash, clear. Okay, Piyush has confusion in androecium part. Very good. Let me just take that question in a minute. Okay, Pallavi is saying got disconnected, so she wants a little recap. Okay, Jatin is also saying one more time. Alright, Shivani has asked a very good question about mother axis, but that mother axis we normally talk about in floral formula. I'm going to take a separate video for formula also. The diagram also. Abdul is saying clear. This is Kairos. Okay, saying no doubt. Okay, mother axis. Shivani has a question. So there are two doubts. One is a revision of androecium. Total stamen are 10. 9 and 1. So 1 is here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. And these 9 stamen are fused. So we show this by connecting it. So these 9 stamen are fused. So we have to put this number in 9 in bracket. That indicates that this is a fused condition. This condition is known as diadelphous condition. This condition is called diadelphous condition, where the stamen fused to form two bundles. Here there are two bundles, one made up of 9 and one is separate. And mother axis we draw here. Mother axis tells us the orientation of the flower. So if this is a branch and here is the flower, so this side becomes the mother axis. Okay, so this is the mother axis. So this tells you the reference point of the axis to which the flower is attached. Okay, Mansi says clear. Difference between bract and ebracteate. If bract is present, we will call it bracteate. If bract is not there, we will call it ebracteate. So in this case, bract can be there, cannot be there. Here we have not written anything. That means there is no bract. So how do you identify that this is the formula of Fabaceae family? There are two characteristics. One is 1 plus 2 plus 2 in the bracket and 9 plus 1. If you see this, then you know it is Fabaceae family. If you talk about Liliaceae family, in Liliaceae family we have lily, onion, garlic, tulip, all these examples. Here, the flower is incomplete. Incomplete means all four whorls are not there. Instead of calyx and corolla, there is only one whorl, which is called perianth. So flower is actinomorphic, flower is bisexual, it may have bract or may not have bract. Then calyx, 3 plus 3, that means total tepals. Instead of calyx, we have to write perianth, P. So instead of calyx and corolla, there is only perianth. So individual members of perianth are called tepals. So there are three and three tepals. So how do we draw? This is, suppose I have made these three tepals. So this is one tepal. This is the second tepal. This is the third tepal. Three tepals. And then there is one more circle. That is one more whorl. And here is one tepal. Here is the second tepal. And here is the third tepal. So total number is six, but they are present in two rings. So we count the tepals in one ring, that is three, and then in the inner ring, that is three. Some members of Liliaceae have these fused. So when we are writing about the family, we have to give these options. 3 plus 3, these three fused, these three fused. Okay? Jatin, it is not parietal ovary, it is parietal placentation. We will discuss about placentation separately. Right now, I am talking only about the formula part. Okay? Because we cannot be discussing all the concepts together. So, there are six tepals in two rings. So, tepals together, the whorl is called perianth. Now, let us come to androecium. Androecium are also six, 3 plus 3. And how are these androecium present? One is present here, the second is present here, the third is present here. And they are connected to these tepals. The next one is present here, in the next ring, here and here. This is connected to this and this. Again, there are two rings. So we will have to write 3 plus 3. And androecium is connected to the tepal. So we show this connection in the form of a line joining androecium with the tepal or the perianth. Then comes gynoecium. Here if you draw the section, the ovary has three compartments. That means it is trilocular ovary. 1, 2 and 3 pistils have combined. So we write 3 and they have fused. It's not separate. It looks like one ovary from outside, but you have three compartments. So that indicate three ovaries have fused to give you that one structure. So we have to put a bracket because it is fused and the ovary is superior. So just by looking at the formula, you know so many things. You know that the flower is incomplete. What is the information that we are getting? From this, it says flower is actinomorphic, flower is bisexual, flower is incomplete because all four whorls are not there. So it is incomplete. Ovary is superior, that means flower is hypogynous. Tepals are six. Tepals, six in two whorls of three each. Stamen, six in two whorls of three each. And they are attached. This condition is known as epitepalous. So it is epitepalous condition. Ovary, superior. So just by looking at the formula, you have written so many characteristic features of the flower. And that is what is represented by the floral formula. Now I have given you the formula and we have interpreted it. If I give you this information, you can write the formula. Right? Odd tepal means, okay, anterior. There are some questions here, let me take. How to remember the examples, Piyush? See, you have to do one family at a time. Take all the examples only of that one family on one day. Don't do the second family. Okay? Here it says, when three gynoecium, then three stigma and three style and ovary. Shivani, it can be all three ovaries fused, all three styles fused, all stigmas fused. But how many ovaries fused? That is indicated by these compartments. So if there are three compartments, that means three are fused. If there are five compartments, that means five are fused. May I know the difference between petal and tepal? Okay. That is prathima. Okay, prathima, petal is the individual member of corolla. The whorl is called corolla. Individual member is called petal. In some flowers, instead of petals or corolla and calyx, they have perianth. Like what happens in lily. So there is no separate calyx corolla, only perianth is there. So the individual member of perianth is known as tepal. Yes, Piyush, noted. Okay, Pallavi says it is crystal clear. Odd sepal anterior. Alright. So now, when I showed you the mother axis thing, this is how it is, right? So this is the axis and this is the flower. So this side is called the posterior side and the opposite side is called anterior side. See, here, this is the posterior side. So in this circle, this tepal is posterior. In this circle, the odd tepal is anterior. This is a pair. This is the odd one. In the outer circle, this is the pair. This is the odd one. Okay, so mother axis side is posterior and the other is anterior. What symbol is used for epipetalous and epiphyllous? No symbol, this line which shows connection. If it is connected with petal, we will show androecium with C. If it is connected with the sepals, we will show connection with A and K. So there is no symbol. That was the question from Jatin, okay? Pushkar is saying everything is clear, very good. So now, if you really want to understand and revise this, go through all the floral formulae, which are of three families or four families. Try to interpret this floral formula in these words, so that when they ask questions, you should be able to either interpret this into words or you can use these words to interpret the formula. They can give you that the flower is actinomorphic and all those things, hypogynous, superior ovary, six tepals in two whorls. Which formula represents this? So you can interpret it into the formula. Piyush, in pedigree analysis, that was on my bilingual channel. So tomorrow we can discuss those doubts, okay? So keep those doubts ready. We will discuss it in tomorrow's class. In the previous questions, yes, Shivani, which question you have doubted? Is it the same topic or some other topic? Shivani, we have to do four families because there is one floral diagram given of Brassicaceae family. So we have to discuss a little bit about Brassicaceae. Jatin, Poaceae family is not in our syllabus, but that is Gramineae family in which the spikelet inflorescence is there. Wheat example of that family. No, Piyush, tepals or perianth does not mean the petals and sepals have fused. I use the word instead. So instead of sepals and petals, there is a different word. So it is not formed by the fusion of two. It is a different word altogether. Shivani, pedigree we will do tomorrow. That because we did this in bilingual, okay? So keep the doubts ready. Tomorrow I'll take your doubts. Ramesh is writing, aapke lecture se maine first grade school lecture exam clear kar liya. Okay, congratulations, Ramesh. Akash. Hello, Akash. Alright. So, we talked about what is the formula. Formula tells us the characteristic features of the flower. And we have interpreted a formula in these characters. So, just by knowing the formula, we know almost everything about the flower. C value. Okay, Piyush, what is the question? Is brassic acid in syllabus? Do we need to know? Akash, little bit. Formula, some important characteristics. Pratima, you're welcome. Okay, I'm waiting for the question, I guess, from Piyush. Okay, Akash, you're welcome. Waseem Ahmed, you're from Pakistan. Okay, okay. I hope you are getting advantage of these lectures. Pallavi, the examples of each family are in the economic importance, like food plants, then fiber plants, then if there is a medicinal plant. So we have to just go as per what is given in NCERT. No, nothing extra. How to remember all the characters? Jatin, we study morphology, right? So in morphology, we need all these, or we study all these characters. Here it is just the interpretation of those. Piyush, I don't have the paper with me. Question 1 of DPP C value. I don't have the question. Bract and bracteole difference. That is Kottai Muthu. Bract is the extra wall. And suppose there are two extra wall. One is a bigger, one is a smaller. The bigger one is called bract and the smaller one is called bracteole. Akanksha. Hello, Akanksha. Alright, you're welcome, Pallavi. Alright, so in the next class, that is tomorrow, we have a bilingual class. So there again, I'm going to come up with one topic and we will discuss that concept and I'm going to give you the questions. Today also, I have given you some questions based on the floral formula, but before you appear, just go over all the family part so that you are able to interpret those formulae correctly and you are able to answer those questions. You will find the link in the description of this video. Akanksha Das, new student, welcome to the class. Akanksha, but I think you joined a little late today. Remember, every day, Monday through Thursday, every day 5 o'clock. Monday, Wednesday, I have on this channel, that is on English channel. Tuesdays and Thursdays on bilingual channel. Every day, I'm discussing a different concept. Egg of an organism is haploid, Piyush. Egg is a gamete. It is always haploid. DPP questions. Kaise puchhenge? Okay, in the doubt sessions. So like if you have doubts in bilingual one, we will discuss it in the bilingual. If you have it in English, like just now Piyush asked me a question. That was from English one. So I answered that. Okay. So now, I'll see you tomorrow at 5 o'clock and we will discuss a new concept. Jatin, we will take a separate concept video on placentation. I'll do that also. Alright? So we will do that placentation thing separately. Okay, so take care. I'll see you tomorrow at 5 and don't forget to solve the questions which I have given you. Bye. Take care.